Greetings, two-stroke fans. What we're going to do today is I'm going to give you a demo of how to plot a cone out onto a flat piece of paper that can then be transcribed onto a piece of sheet metal. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make the measurements fit this, so what I can do is once I've done the cone, then I can use these to check the dimensions, okay? So I can show you that they actually match what they're supposed to be. So now we will magically jump to the software and we'll enter the figures of 64mm base, 20mm tip, 100mm centre length, and for the purpose we're going to put a sheet material sheet in of zero, but normally you would put in the thickness of the actual sheet metal that you are using. You can do this, scribe this directly onto sheet metal, but I would actually do it onto paper, because you might find you want to make another expansion chamber, and then you can just take the pieces of paper out and scribe them on some sheet metal again. Okay, here we are at our plot window. We'll put the diameter of the base section in, which we had at 64mm, 20mm ID for our tip section. Centre length is 100mm, and because we're just going to make a paper one, we actually just put zero in for the sheet thickness on top. So we hit plot cone. There's our numbers that we're going to use.
So here we are back again. I've got a piece of paper stuck down. I've now got the dimensions that I want for the cone. First thing we want to do is go across here and just put a datum point, which will be the centre of where we're going to take our compass point. Our first measurement will be the D measurement that runs outwards. So the D radius is the first radius for the base section. The C radius is the smaller one. So I'll start out with a larger one. Now it's 148.93. Yep. Rightio. First one from our line. Second one, our C dimension is 46.54. If you want to do it in Imperial with your vernier and measure the compass and whatever, there's a little metric converter in the software, in the input calculator values window. 46.54, so we'll go down to 46.5, okay, put that in our point, our inside one, go all the way around, you know. Next point, take your pen, pencil, whichever, put it on the datum point there, and draw a line across there. Okay, pretty easy so far. Now the next one is our A dimension, which will be the chordal width across. 186.14, place that there. That one there, mark our spot, take our ruler from there, back to our point down here, our little datum point down here where we had that, okay. Yep, and draw a line from there. And there we go. The B dimension is not actually required, but I put the B dimension in there so you can just cross check the figures and just to make sure it's right. 58.17. So we'll just go to 58.1, and we'll just measure that to there, Okay. So a distance across there, the B measurement correlates with what we should have. Don't use the B one, okay, because it's just more accurate to use the A one across here. All right, the B one is just provided so that you can just cross-check the figures. If you measure the B one and that's not right, then you probably want to double-check all the figures that you've used before you cut everything out. There we go. Now I'll talk a little bit about actually rolling the cones in a later video. We'll get into that. There's a few methods to do that, but I'll be honest with you. Look, if you know a sheet metal place where you buy the sheet metal, and he's got a small set of rollers, and he can roll the cones for you in the rollers first, and leave you to do the rest of the welding, then get it done, because you know actually rolling the metal can be a bit of a pain to do. You've got to keep putting it through the rollers and through the rollers. And there's other ways that we can beat that around, but you won't get as neat a job. And just remember that when you're making an expansion chamber, you know, it's a tuned pipe. Neat is the name of the game. We've got to keep it neat. That's why, as I said, no weld beads inside the pipe or anything like that. And you'll see, when you're actually rolling the sheet and you go to weld it together, by the time you finish welding, by the time you finish rolling that sheet, okay, you'll find that you can't roll sheet metal without distorting it to some degree, and those little distortions will leave you with an edge that's not quite perfect around the top and not quite perfectly flat around the bottom once you've actually rolled it all out through the rollers. And that's why, as I said before, always go to the outside of the line a bit, a little bit of extra metal, so that when you make your cone, you can stick down some paper and you can and rub the cones on each end, you know. If you've got a linisher, you can use that and bring your sizes down to size, okay. Now, let's just do some checking on our cone, all right, and there we go, 20 millimeter. All right, we'll push that down to our top there. Check our center length, which was 100. There you go. Our center length there, which is 100. And our base diameter, which was 64. Okay, as you can see. So, now if you need a cone to be an angle at the top like that, okay, what you would normally do is you would pie slice the cone and then slice it round here and then tilt the cone and put the other piece in. But what you can do is you can actually use a calculator, and I will give you a link to the calculator, which Nico from Hollandaren channel sent me. If you don't know Nico's channel, I'll put a link there. Go to his channel. He's nearly got 1,000 subscribers, so he needs more subscribers, that's for sure. But he does two-stroke stuff. He's doing a scratch-built four-cylinder two-stroke engine at the moment. That's pretty radical, and so you might enjoy watching that as well. So Nico sent me a link to some software. It's payware, unfortunately, but it is what it is. And with that, you can put the cone sizes into it, and it will actually print out ones that have an angle included in the top, in the plot. So when you cut it out of the paper, it's already got the angle in there, and when you put it onto the metal. So then you might want an angled one, say, if you've got a two-stroke motocross pipe where you've got a diffuser cone coming up and a neutral chamber here, and then you want to have a right angle inside part of the diffuser so you can take sections. But if you've got any more questions on that, put it in the comments section. As always, I always answer questions. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. Hit the bell notification, because YouTube likes to hide my videos away. And most of all, if you like the videos, please share them, because YouTube doesn't. And that would be much appreciated. If anyone needs the software, or if you think anyone wants the software, please share it. It's freeware. I don't charge anything. I don't make anything out of it. So, that will do it for today. Until next time, bye for now.